Hariyum children, our topic of discussion is animal tissue, structure and function of different type of animal tissue. First we will see the flow chart of animal tissue. Animal tissue comprises of four category: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and nervous tissue. Epithelial tissue is of five categories: squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, ciliated epithelium and stratified squamous epithelium. Connective tissue basically four category: areolar tissue, adipose tissue, skeletal tissue and fluid connective tissue. Areolar tissue is of two type: tendon and ligament, and skeletal tissue is also two type: bone and cartilage. Fluid tissue is of two type: bone and limb. We will go to third category, muscular tissue. It is of three category type: striated muscles, smooth muscles and cardiac muscle. Then finally we will read nervous tissue. Let's have a detailed notation of all tissue. We will see epithelial tissue first, and here in the picture it is showing five category of tissues. Squamous epithelium, you can see it is very thin layer cell and it is normally function is for protection, and this cell are found in the outer layer of skin. We will go to cuboidal epithelium. The name indicate it is cuboid in shape. It is normally found in kidney and its basic function is for absorption. We will go to stratified squamous epithelium, which is just like squamous epithelium, but it is a column like cells are there, and this is also find it is normally found in the outer part in the inner lining of the mouth cavity. We will go to columnar epithelial tissue, which is column like cell, vertically arranged cell, and this tissue is basic function is for secretion, and it is found in the inner lining of stomach and intestine. We will go to the next tissue, which is ciliated columnar epithelium. This is just like columnar epithelium tissue, but it has cilia. So normally it is located in the windpipe and it contains with cilia. Okay, we will see how these tissues are arranged in a living body. Here is a living body, you see, and in this body we see the first stratified squamous epithelium, and it is the layered cell. The squamous epithelium, simple thin layer cell, layer after layer the cell is present, and normally it is found in the inner lining of mouth cavity. We are going to the second category, pseudo stratified columnar epithelium, which is also known as ciliated epithelium cell, and it is found in the windpipe and they help in lashing of the substances. We are going to the simple squamous epithelium, found in a inner organ. Then we are going to simple columnar epithelium. The columnar epithelium are vertical cell found in the stomach and intestine. Then we are going to cuboidal cell, which is found in the kidney, which is cuboidal in nature, a structure and function is for absorption. We will see what is the basic characteristic feature of epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue are specialized cell because they are present over throughout our skin and they can contact to each and every part of the cells through the body. This is polarity in nature because the cell can connect to the different type of cells and different things. There is no blood supply, so they are avascularity in their nature. They can regenerate, means they can divide to make new cell. Generally it happens to our outer body part. Then we will see the cellularity. Lot of cells are present, they are close contact to each other. So these are the basic characteristic feature of epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is the free surface tissue. It is found in the basement membrane, and though it function is protection, its function is absorption, secretion, right? So it is a basic tissue of the living body. We will see the next tissue, muscular tissue. This tissue is of three categories: striated, smooth and cardiac. Striated muscles are voluntary in nature. Voluntary means they are under our control. Smooth muscles are involuntary in nature, and cardiac is also involuntary in nature. We will see the structure. So skeletal muscle, which is called voluntary muscle, normally found in the outer part of our body, in a bicep and tricep. Look at the picture. The bands are present, nucleus is present is there, and we will say to the smooth muscle, down part you say, spindle shaped muscles are present, and normally they are involuntary in nature. So they are found in the internal organ of our body, in the bladder and intestine. It is found. It is spindle shaped. We'll go to the third category, cardiac muscle. Those are also involuntary in muscle. It's a special type of muscle which carry the both the character of skeletal as well as smooth muscles. We will see what are the basic characteristics feature of muscular tissue. Muscular tissue, first character we will say, it is a character of, it can receive and respond to stimulation, right? That means it is excitability in nature. It is contractile, it can be certain, it can be thickened, means expand and compound. It is extendibility character is there, the tissue can lengthen, right? And it is elastic in nature, it can return back to its resting state. We will see next tissue is connective tissue. You will see connective tissue is basically three category: connective tissue proper, skeletal connective tissue, and vascular connective tissue. In the connective tissue proper, we will find areolar tissue, adipose tissue, white fibrous tissue, yellow elastic tissue, and reticular tissue. In skeletal tissue, we will find cartilage and bone. Cartilage are again three category: hyaline cartilage, fibrous cartilage, calcified cartilage, and in bone we'll find compact bone and spongy bone. In vascular tissue we shall be saying blood and lymph. We will see in our body where these all connective tissue are located. We will see the first A, you see it is a loose connective tissue present under the skin, right? So it is the areolar tissue which is present under the skin, with the cell and collagen fibers are present. We will go to the adipose tissue. It is a tissue present. Its basic function is to store fats, right? Fat droplets are present in adipose tissue. We will go to next. It is your blood, that is a fluid connective tissue, right? Which is present throughout your body as a fluid liquid mass. Then we will go to the fibrous connective tissue. Here it is showing ligament, which is ligament normally found bone to bone, right? The connection between bones to another bone by collagen fiber is ligament, whereas another fibrous tissue is tendon, which is connect to muscles to bone. We will see the next fibrous tissue, or it is a skeletal tissue, that is a cartilage, which is present in the end part of the bone, and normally cartilage contains some cells and matrix. We normally found cartilage in our nose, in our ear, that is pinna. We will find also in the rib cage. We are going to the next hard part of the tissue, that is your bone, contained with matrix, and it has got a central canal. We will see what are the basic features of connective tissue. We will see connective tissue, the name indicated, connect to every part of the body. It is fibrous cell, contained with the ground substances. It is highly vascular in nature, means blood cells are present. It produce this tissue fibrous in nature, as well as ground tissue connection is also there. Functionally, they are binding in nature, they are supporting tissue, they are packaging tissue like your areolar tissue. They protect the body and they can repair like blood cell. They defense, provide you defense from all type of injuries and all. It is provide insulation and as well as help in transportation. We will see the last tissue, that is called nervous tissue. Here is a picture shows typical neuron. You look at this. It is an elongated cell of our body. It has basically got three parts. That is your nucleus, that is your site, and contain the cell body. You see cell body called as site. It contain with nucleus. There is a fibrous thin thread like structure which is called dendrites. This is basic second part, and a long slender position that is called axon. So basically cell body, dendrite, and axon. This axon has a sheath outer covering called myelin sheath, and the connection to each myelin sheath you are getting node of Ranvier, and the end terminal part of the axon is called axon terminal. It is an elongated cell. Why? Because it has to communicate throughout the body. It create a coordination and balance in our body. We shall be going to basic feature of nervous tissue as well as location. This tissue normally found in the brain, spinal cord, nerves, and throughout the body. Its basic function is to transmit signal, it coordinate, regulate and integrate the body function. This characteristic is that respond to the change in the surrounding and they create a balance in our body. So we read the different type of tissue. Thank you.